nijoro twizihizaga twibukaga isabukuru y'imyaka 25 mfite inama nshaka kubagira Let me change to English so that people don't misunderstand what I'm saying. There is tonight. Tonight, I think, ends before you run into a Friday. Today we are Thursday. It's midnight. We still have a few minutes. But we are transitioning from celebration of 25 years today of liberation. That means we are going to have another 25 years ahead. I promise you, most of us will still be there. But while we have finished 25 years and we're going to spend another 25 years to remember also, we are not going to have another Thursday ending the 25 years since liberation. So my advice is this one. Let's party tonight like there is not... Like indeed, there is not going to be another Thursday like tonight. That is advice number one. Advice number two. My advisors came to me. First of all, when they were advising me to say something, I said, okay, what do you advise me to say? They had nothing. They just told me they are only advising me to say something. Then I had to figure out what to say. So for tomorrow is a Friday. It's a start, it's the beginning of another 25 years. But Friday is also supposed to be a working day. Then I was asking myself, what do I say about tomorrow? Then I consulted one official, the Prime Minister, our Prime Minister, and said, what should I say about tomorrow? He wasn't sure. So I said, you know what? I'm going to be meaningfully vague. So I'm going to have to say something of a meaning, but also vague, or vaguely meaningful. So then I said, you know what? I told the Prime Minister, you know what I'm going to say? They know. I'm going to tell these people that tomorrow, don't do what you don't want to do. So let me tell you what I meant. I know many people here. On one hand, they have a commitment to go to work. But they really don't want to go to work. So, what I was trying to say, therefore, really don't do what you don't want to do. That is a vague way of saying that tomorrow is a holiday. Okay? Let me finish on the third point. As we were coming over here with our guests, President Gingob of Namibia and the First Lady of Namibia, I also told them I had a bit of advice for them. And I told them, I said, Your Excellency President, in Rwanda, we do or we take everything seriously. And even when it is partying, we do it seriously. So I advise the president that, and madam that you should not be surprised when they see people doing their thing with the party seriously. So all the best to you.